I have a question for Deepa. Deepa and I have met many times before, so we've even talked about this in the past. Deepa, you're a Khel Ratna awardee. You're a Paralympic medalist. You're the president of the Paralympic Committee of India. What are the challenges in your daily life, though, outside of the glamour of the sports arena, etc., in your daily life? Because we all know India has some of the poorest disability access spaces, especially in the public domain. So if you can give us some idea of the challenges you face, I think that will really shine a light on the challenges that everyone struggles with on a daily basis in this country, those who can't, those who are challenged in one way or the other.
Thank you, Rahul. Yes, challenges are there, but my country is fast changing. The fact that I am a member of the panel right here, right now, treated at par, and we are having this discussion itself shows that we are at the cusp of very good change. Talking about challenges, I have been hearing the conversation since morning, and I've been listening to this word, access to good health, access to vaccination, access to nutrition, access to employability. Let me just say that for me or for anybody in disability, the first word itself is the biggest challenge. You just have to pick up access and call it accessibility, and that itself is the challenge. So access to health, access to nutrition, access to opportunities will come only when we have first discussed accessibility. And accessibility, not just a physical accessibility, where I talk about tactile tiles, I talk about ramps, I talk about public transportation, or I talk about the pathways or the footpaths or universal accessibility. But I will also talk about accessibility in the minds of the people. The mindset should also be accessible, where you accept disability as, a person living in a disability does not become an outcast or all the taboos around it. And then also comes the accessibility in the digital world. The pandemic has made the entire world digital. They have come to realize that work from home is possible. Even those who did not have a disability contributed to the economies, to the workforce, to continuity of maintaining work in any organization from home and through the digital platforms. Now, all websites, are they accessible? All digital applications, softwares are accessible. So that is another very strong part of accessibility that I'll talk about. So these are the major challenges, infrastructure, mindsets, digitalization has come a big way. But the silver lining in the pandemic has been that work can be done from home. People who are mobile, who have mobility challenges, that does not mean that they cannot participate in economy. They can also sit on a computer at home and contribute to any economy. And practically the world has moved from home now. So I hope that has increased faith in abilities of people with disabilities. One. And I very would also like to add here that if opportunities are not served, thanks to the policies which have become inclusive, I can talk about sports. Not a single policy discriminates with players in disability. And the results are showing. The entire nation has celebrated medals, gold medals, the world records that have recently been created. Pandemic's win of humanity was nothing but Olympics and Paralympics, where the whole world came together and celebrated fitness through sports. They celebrated coming together. That was, I think, the first platform post-pandemic, where the entire world came together and the entire world looked at it that, yes, health and fitness is possible and a healthy competition is possible during pandemic. And through that, India celebrated 19 medals that were just won in Tokyo 2020, which itself says, yeah, if I may quote statistics, there were 3 million, 2.6 million hits coming on one single update of a medal won by a physically challenged athlete, by a para athlete for India. An International Paralympic Committee, United Nations, they were so happy, and we were personally getting calls of congratulations that India is responding so well to these medals. The maximum social media engagement has come through India, and we were given a special letter of appreciation, which means that India is ready to celebrate a physically challenged person and their abilities. They are loving their achievements. They are calling them sources of inspiration, and not just inspiration, but also jubilation and respect for the tricolor. So this is a changing India. And like Aradhana said, more opportunities and mainstream, and not just empathy. Fitness, I think sports is the biggest medium and best medium to socially integrate. When you see one physically challenged person playing in a sporting arena along with 10 people with no disability, automatically those 10 families get sensitized towards the abilities. They start looking at a person with a different point of view. And that's what we need to do.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Deepa
Malik. Excellent.
Thank you so much for being such an inspiration.